Hello guys, welcome back to Mano Cooks. In today's video, let's see an instant breakfast recipe which is semiya idli or vermicelli idli. Along with that, I'll show you a garlic chutney which is spicy and goes really well with this idli. So let's get started. Yeah, so keep a pan and to that add 1 teaspoon oil. To that I'm adding 1 cup semiya or vermicelli or semai. So just add that to the pan and let's go ahead and roast this. So the first step is to roast the semiya. So we'll be roasting the semiya until a light golden color. So be very careful, don't keep the flame on high, just do it on medium flame or medium low flame. Now as you see on the video, it is totally roasted. So now I'm taking 2 tablespoons semiya out of that and keeping it in a bowl, and rest of the semiya I'm transferring it in a big bowl and keep it aside. Now to the same pan, let's add 1 more teaspoon oil, and to that add 1 cup suji or rava and start roasting the rava. So don't change the color of the rava, just roast the rava until every grain is heated up. So I'm checking it right now and it is ready. So now let's transfer this to the same bowl where we have kept semiya and let it cool down. To the same pan, again I'm adding 1 tablespoon oil, and to that let's go ahead and add mustard seeds. So allow mustard seeds to crackle. Now add chana dal to the pan and let's roast the chana dal for few seconds. After which I'm adding urad dal, and we have to roast this until the dals change lightly golden in color. Now you can see the dals are golden in color. So at this point I'm adding grated ginger and just saute it in the heat in the pan. And now you can just go ahead and turn off the flame and add the red chili and green chili which I have kept chopped. Finally, now let's go ahead and add a few chopped coriander leaves, and with that let's go ahead and transfer this tempering into the suji and vermicelli mix. So now our vermicelli idli mix is ready. Now we have to allow this to completely cool down before we add the next ingredients. So let's keep this aside. Now to the same pan, let's add 1 teaspoon ghee to it, and once ghee melts I'm adding few cashew nuts. Let's go ahead and roast the cashew nuts until golden brown. So again, be very careful, they get roasted really quick. So you can keep the flame on low and roast it until nice golden. And now take this aside and keep it aside. Let's now go ahead and check the vermicelli idli mix. It has cooled down completely. To that, let's add salt. And with that, I'm adding curd 1 cup. Now to this, let's go ahead and add 3/4 cup water. After adding water, let's go ahead and mix everything very well until the curd, water and semiya and rava, everything is mixed well and the consistency should be like this. Now let's go ahead and cover this and allow it to rest for 10 to 15 minutes. While our idli batter is resting, let's go ahead and apply some ghee and grease all the idli molds and keep it ready. Now we have greased the idli molds. Now to this, let's go ahead and add the cashew nut which we have roasted it. After that, let's go ahead and add the semiya which we have kept aside. This is just for decoration. If you, it looks very good when you do this. Now let's check back on the idli batter that we have kept aside. So it has rested for 15 minutes right now and see how thick it has become. The suji and the semiya both have soaked the curd and the water very well. To this now I'm adding 1 teaspoon Eno fruit salt. To activate the Eno fruit salt, let's go ahead and add 2 tablespoon or 4 tablespoon water. And now let's go ahead and mix the whole batter nicely. Once we add Eno and mix the batter, it becomes really fluffy and soft. Now this batter is in the right consistency. Let's go ahead and scoop the batter and pour it in the greased idli molds. In the meantime, you can keep the idli steamer to boil water. So once this is ready, let's go ahead and keep it in the idli steamer and let's steam this for exactly 10 to 12 minutes. After 12 minutes, let's open the idli steamer and let's touch and see the idlis. They are really cooked well, see it's not sticking to your fingers. Now let it cool down a little bit and after that, you can dip a spoon in water and take out the idlis. See how nice the idlis are. These semiya or vermicelli idlis are very very soft and fluffy, and you can see how colorful and vibrant they look. So let's go ahead and learn a great garlic chutney for this. So for the garlic chutney, let's heat the same pan, and to that I'm adding gingerly oil, and to that let's add 1/4 cup onion. Let's saute the onion in oil until the onion turns little pink in color. Onion is pink in color. To this I'm adding 1/4 cup chopped garlic cloves. I like to keep the quantity of onion and garlic same, but if you want you can add a little bit more garlic also here. So after this I'm adding a small tamarind piece to this, and Let's keep sauteing this. Now to this, let's add 1/2 teaspoon salt and again saute this. To this now it's time to add dried red chili. So I'm adding Kashmiri red chilies here. If you want, you can go ahead and add the spicy red chili. So adjust it according to your spice level. Now that the onion has changed color and the garlic is also trying to become brown and then the red chili, everything is sauteed. Let's go ahead and turn off the stove and transfer this to a mixie jar and let's completely cool this down before we grind it. After the mixture cools down, let's go ahead and grind the mixture without adding water and grind it until this stage. And right now after this, you can add a little bit water and you can grind it to a smooth paste. Don't add water in the starting, just add water after the red chilies are crushed very well. So like this, I have added 2 to 3 times water and then ground it like a smooth paste. You can see the color of this chutney. It is really spicy and yummy chutney, which goes really well with the semiya idli. Now heat a small pan and to that add generous amount of gingerly oil. Gingerly oil really gives a nice taste to this chutney. Once oil is hot, add little mustard seeds. Once they crackle, add little bit of urad dal. Allow everything to splutter. Right now let's go ahead and add few dry red chilies and after that add few curry leaves to this. After curry leaves splutter in oil, let's go ahead and transfer this tempering onto the chutney that we have prepared. So that is my best recipe of a spicy garlic chutney along with the instant breakfast semiya and vermicelli idli. Do try this at home, friends, and thank you so much for watching.